Welcome to Sonic Fit, lesson on letter names on the treble and bass clef. The last lesson was on line notes and space notes, which alternate to ascend a staff. This allows the notes to show pitch. We identify these pitches using alphabet letter names A through G and place those on the staff according to the clef. The two most common clefs in use today are the treble clef for higher notes and the bass clef for lower notes. We'll start with the bass clef. It originated by putting an F on the staff to show where F is, and the two lines that make the top part of the F would be placed on either side of the line that is F. Today, it's the two dots on the bass clef. From that line, we can find all the other notes. To go one note higher than G, we don't go to H. Instead, we go to A, because it's the same note as the A below. These are called different octaves of the same note. The treble clef, used for higher notes, originated by placing a G on the staff with the curly circle around the line G. As with the bass clef, once you know one note, you can find the rest. Remember, one note higher than G is A, and then alternating lines and spaces, we can go up or down to find the alphabet letters of the notes. A skilled musician immediately knows the alphabet letter of any note that they see. As you build to become such a skilled musician, it helps to have a couple shortcuts in your back pocket. Here are some mnemonic devices. The spaces of the treble clef spell face, F-A-C-E. The spaces of the bass clef spell ace-G, or you might prefer all cows eat grass. For the treble clef lines, you might know one of many mnemonic devices. Elephants go back doing flips is my favorite. The one I grew up with was every good boy does fine. And for the bass clef lines, get back down fine animal to accompany the elephants. And the one I grew up with, bass clef lines, was good boys do fine always. I think if you know the spaces, then you can, that's a great place to be and get quick at finding what the lines are between the spaces. So here's the review of face for treble clef spaces, ace G for bass clef spaces. Welcome to Sonic Fit. We're working on flashcard letter names. You can click on knit letter names. You have these settings to deal with. Let's give ourselves lots of time for problem. And we're going to focus on just the treble clef now without leisure lines. So you're working on these letters, F, A, so that would be A, F, A, C, E, so the next one up would be F, okay? And you want to get until you're really fast at these. Change settings to bass clef, and the next problem will be in bass clef. Bass clef spaces, ace, G, A, C, E. So that one's E. A, C, E. Between C and E, C, D, E. So that would be D. And again, you want to get until you're really fast with these.